will take time to come to terms with everything that happened in the Dominion. But time is the one thing we always seem to lack.
See the pair that got hauled into tyres?
Aye. All their fancy silks stained red.
Thanks for not leaving me in the Dominion. If you hadn't come back, I might still be stuck there. I told Nan we flew back on the Phoenix, but she walloped me for telling fibs. Can you tell her it was the truth, Clive?
Aye, it's a dangerous world out there.
Best stock up while you can. The whole realm's in chaos. But as the old saying goes, then. You're rubbing me blind, you know. Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way. Clive. Go on, then. Finished, are you?
Trouble with your gear, or... fraying about us, guys. Unless that is... what's saying for you, dear? Bad, if I do say so myself. Anything else?
Still alive, are you? Go on, then.
else?
You got out else? I reckon I can find a buyer.
Is that all?
Clive. If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. I reckon I can find a buyer. You got out else? I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. You got out else? I'm thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. You got out else? I'm thankful you got that much. You got out else? I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. You got out else? I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. You got out else? I'm thankful you got that much. You got out else? I'm thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. I'm thankful you got that much. You got out else? I'm thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer.
Not find a better price than that.
It'd better all be here.
It seems the hideaway's lost its.
Thank you.
what the curse breakers brought back from Dalmechia. Said they were all the rage in Dalamil. Looks sort of funny if you ask me.
I'll be damned.
Have you had one before?
Something smells good. What are we having?
Balms! And they are good. You should try one.
Eh? The bloody great hole in it. Who ate the rest?
It's supposed to be hollow, silly. Haven't you ever seen Drake's Fang?
Seems the hideaway's lost its appetite. Can you blame them, with the skulls as they are? Will we ever see the sun again?
Mother, save us.
Might be hard now there's only one.
Then we're all doomed.
There's barely been a shipment in since the skies started boiling. A few more days without a visit and we'll have to start eating the blankets.
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that.
What are you making them skies then?
An omen is what?
How may I help you today, Clive?
Not true.
We've lost so much already.
Is everything we've received and everything promised? All yours. Come again. I may have more for you.
There's talk of these skies driving men mad.
The battle cries of dread one time.
Otto, how fares the realm?
The realm? Oh, she's just fine. As long as you look past the fat storms out mother crystals and her skies are a roiling cesspit.
And Gav?
He's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project. Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turned foul. Still waiting on a reply, though.
Do you have any good news?
Well, that depends on your definition of good.
All right, fine. What do you suggest we do?
Oh, no, I'm just the messenger. I leave the scheme into those more suited to the task. Could be that Lady Vivian and Old Tomes have their own thoughts on the current state of things. Could be that they don't. It certainly can't hurt to ask.
I suppose not.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable catastrophe? Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate. No one could have predicted the actions of the Crown Prince.
I'm sorry I couldn't save your home.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits. They'll be back on their feet in no time.
I hope so.
Look at us. Bluer than a pair of bog crabs. Tempting though it may be, sulking will not help us find a solution to this mess.
You believe there's one to be found?
I don't know. But I am certain we're more likely to find it if we first examine the facts. Beneath these darkened skies, fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen Mother Crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces, now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves. And amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest nation would falter. Rosaria and the Iron Kingdom teeter on the brink of collapse, while the tragedy in Twinside has all but paralyzed the Holy Empire. Dalmechia fares little better. Rumor has it the ministers fled the capital after the fall of Drake's Fang, leaving their beloved republic to crumble. Walud, meanwhile, moves in earnest. The Einherjar has been sighted off Storm. The world, in short, is in chaos. It would seem our civilization was nothing but a castle of sand, to be washed away at the whim of the waves.
A castle of sand.
Not my best flourish, but it seemed fitting. The reports I've received are considerably more blunt in their appraisal. Without the protection of their nations, it will fall to the people to defend themselves against those who would take what is theirs.
Which is only ever going to end one way.
Defending a farmhouse against a band of chocobo thieves is one thing, but pitchforks and palisades will do little to stall an army's advance. Should the King of Walud deign to invade, there would be none to stop him.
None but us.
Oh, the moon. Sid, did you know that chocobos are far more resilient to the effects of ether than most other beasts? Some say that's one of the reasons they were tamed for use as mounts and sumpters, so that an ether flood wouldn't mean instant death for their riders or drivers. Me, I reckon they built it up over generations. Too many foolish traders driving their birds into floods, and only the toughest surviving.
Let me guess. You're here about the skies.
Is there anything you don't know, Lawsman?
It doesn't take a court astrologer to augur the obvious. As for what has disturbed the heavens, that, I believe, is a question the Fallen might be better placed to answer than I. And on the sixth day, did the gods tear the sun from the firmament, visiting darkness upon their prideful sons and daughters? But I dare say you remember your childhood lessons on the sins of Zemeckis only too well.
You think they're connected? That Ultima was one of the gods responsible?
Well, he has certainly exhibited powers that we mortals would associate with the divine.
There is nothing divine about him.
But he wouldn't be the first god of whom that could be said, now would he? Yet for all the fairy tales that tell of the sins, there is almost nothing in the way of actual historical accounts. Had I the Journal of Moss the Chronicler, I may have been able to tell you more, but alas, I fear all remaining copies have been lost to time. You will forgive me, I hope?
Certainly not. Because there is nothing to forgive. Even without this journal, you've provided us ample wisdom. And we will always be grateful for it. Perhaps Otto will be more inclined to share his thoughts when he hears what the others had to say.
Clive, we have a problem.
Only one. That would be a first.
It would. Actually, there are three. We had as many owls arrive while you were at the shelves. Martha's got a Akashic out her gates, and talk of monsters roaming the hills outside of Northreach has put the wind up Isabel and her lot.
And don't forget Dalimil. Lubor says the village was raided by bandits.
When it rains,
it fucking pours. The Cursebreakers are spread thin, taking stock of the damage in the Dominion. And even if I could get word to all of them, I doubt they'd get here in time to make any real difference. Which means there's only two people who can.
Jill and I.
Let them know we're on our way.
Fancy a look at the list, do you?
I don't mean to be gloomy. They need all the help they can get. Quick look.
Seen enough?
I can hardly lift my arms. The curse, it's...
You just need some rest.
The injuries suffered by both your brother and the prince were bad enough. But that wound above Joshua's heart is unlike anything I've ever seen. Were he not a dominant, I fear he would have succumbed to it long ago.
Let's go. Run like the wind.
It's over!
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that. Faster!
We're not alone.
It should have stayed in its shell.